The US economy would have gone into a recession this year, if it weren't for the AI bubble. Will the AI bubble get bigger or burst in 2026? Why is the brewing trouble at OpenAI a big problem for the AI bubble? And what does it mean for your money? The trend is your best friend, as they say on Wall Street. Stocks surge and the dollar sagged in 2025. And true to form, Wall Street's newly released year-ahead reports are doubling down on the same playbook for 2026. Across the street, banks are forecasting another year of strong equities and a weaker dollar. Behind these forecasts are two key assumptions. One, the AI boom is set to continue. Two, the productivity gains from AI adoption will help drive down inflation and allow the Fed to keep cutting interest rates. I agree that the 2026 outlook depends critically on AI. I also agree that AI is ultimately deflationary. What I have a problem with is the consensus that the AI capex boom will continue into 2026. I think this is much less certain than it looks. AI-related capex spending contributed to 92% of US GDP growth in the first half of 2025. If we also factor in the massive wealth created by the AI rally that supported household spending, it is not unreasonable to say that the US economy would have gone into a recession in 2025 if it hadn't been for AI. If AI was important in 2025, it will be no less important in 2026. Indeed, OECD this week highlighted as a key risk in 2026, a stock market correction triggered by the bursting of the AI bubble. I agree with this assessment, except I see the bursting of the AI bubble as more than a risk. It is my central scenario. And this is why. The AI bubble has been driven by the surge in AI-related capex spending. Investors are assuming that the only reason why companies like Microsoft, Amazon, and Google will pour hundreds of billions of dollars into AI is because of high expected returns that their investments offer. In other words, investors have come to see AI-related capex spending as a proxy of AI's future returns. This is why the stock prices of these companies have become so correlated with their AI-related capex spending. This is why the more they spend, the more their stocks have gone up, with the positive feedback loop sending their valuation to lofty heights. This has been the story of 2025. I'm skeptical that this will continue in 2026. Over the past 3 months, OpenAI has announced a series of high-profile partnerships with other major players in AI. With NVIDIA, AMD, Broadcom, and Foxconn to lock in the advanced chips and other hardware needed for the build-out of its own data center network. With hyperscalers including Amazon, Google, CoreWeave, and Oracle to secure supplemental computing power for training and deploying its next generation of AI models. With these deals, OpenAI has committed to invest $1.4 trillion in compute infrastructure over the next 8 years. The news sent the AI trade into a frenzy. Once again, the market decided to equate spending with future returns. Investors didn't care how OpenAI, with a revenue of just $12 billion, would be able to pay for these commitments. With OpenAI's commanding 80% market share among chatbots, the market was willing to give it the benefit of doubt. Then came the release of Google's Gemini 3.0 on November 18th. Unlike ChatGPT 5.0, whose debut sparked only lukewarm interest, Gemini 3.0 has been met with universally positive reviews. Gemini 3.0 outperforms ChatGPT in several areas. These include multimodal reasoning, complex instruction following, and creative agentic coding tasks. For the first time, Google, not OpenAI, appears to have the momentum. The problem for the AI bubble is that if OpenAI is no longer the undisputed leader, then its trillion-dollar capex promise looks like a lot of hot air. For OpenAI, competition is not only coming from Google. Last month, the Chinese startup Moonshot released its Kimi K2 thinking model. It immediately overtook ChatGPT 5.0 in the Villain LLM leaderboard for the most challenging benchmarks across multiple domains. This is notwithstanding Kimi K2 thinking model cost only $4.6 million to train. Meanwhile, China's DeepSeek just releases two new models, DeepSeek version 3.2 and DeepSeek version 3.2 Special, that come close to matching other frontier models in mathematical reasoning and coding. And guess what? The 3.2 is free. I argue in a previous video why I thought the market is underestimating the sheer difficulty companies like OpenAI face in monetizing their technology. My thinking has not changed. As competition intensifies, prices will fall, and so will the expected returns. As expected returns fall, the market will be forced to look at AI-related capex in a very different light. If Gemini 3.0 is bad news for OpenAI, it is not much better for Microsoft. OpenAI's models such as ChatGPT 4, ChatGPT 5 have been the foundational technology powering Microsoft's Copilot programs across Windows, Microsoft 365, Bing, and Edge. The information reported this week that Microsoft had lower sales growth forecasts for certain artificial intelligence products. Microsoft denied the report, but the stock sold off. Microsoft may try to double down on its own series of LLMs, known as MAI. But if history is any guide, it is hard to imagine them closing the gap with Google. Microsoft has rarely led in foundational AI research, and the company's track record shows that it is a fast follower, not a frontier innovator. Will Microsoft try to compensate by increasing its AI-related capex spending further? I cannot rule it out, but the market will see through it very quickly, as this would just speed up the commoditization of data centers that will do little good for the profit margins of also other hyperscalers like Amazon, not to mention CoreWeave and Oracle. Another company that will be negatively affected by Gemini 3.0 is, of course, Tesla. With struggling car sales, Tesla is selling itself these days as an AI and robotic company. If multimodal reasoning-rich foundation models outperform Tesla's FSD stack, Tesla has a big problem. Google's Waymo already leads Tesla in robo-taxis, and Gemini 3.0 can help cement that lead. What does Gemini 3.0 mean for NVIDIA? Google trained Gemini on its own TPU chips, so NVIDIA will not benefit if Google decides to scale up its data centers. But the real threat for NVIDIA is coming from China. China just demonstrated that the scaling frontier is not hardware bound, it is algorithm bound. Chinese AI models are proofs that expensive NVIDIA chips are not needed to train frontier models. The AI trade in 2025 was all about capex. In 2026, I think the market will shift its focus to how AI companies will make money. The problem is that as competition intensifies, making money will likely prove more difficult than spending money. I think the current valuation of the AI sector is very difficult to justify. I think the market will arrive at this conclusion sooner rather than later. When it does, it will not only have massive impact on the US stock market, but for US rates and for the US dollar too. A bursting of the AI bubble is bullish for my 5 sterling steepener, and bearish, of course, for the US dollar. Thank you for listening.